With the massive acceleration and growth by Quest Nutrition, will the Simply Good Foods company become the next $1 billion active nutrition CPG portfolio? On July 1st of 2021, the Simply Good Foods company did report its fiscal 2021 quarter three earnings. So I'm gonna be running through some of that high level financial data, and that's gonna give you guys an update on how the Simply Good Foods company portfolio is performing in the current business environment. But more importantly, I'm gonna pull this back and hopefully give you guys some more strategic insights around trending health and fitness snacking space. Just as I've done on the quarterly content for Simply Good Foods company, I did provide some of the slides. So if you are watching this on YouTube, you would be able to see some of the company provided charts and other things to really help you visualize the financial elements better. Now, for new community members that maybe are not too familiar with the Simply Good Foods company, it's actually a brand portfolio that is made up of two brands. The first one is Atkins Nutritionals, and the second one is Quest Nutrition. So just jumping into that high level financial data, 2021 quarter three revenue for the Simply Good Foods company was $284 million. That was up 32% year over year and up 23% quarter over quarter on a sequential basis. North America was up 30.7% year over year. International was up 2.3% year over year. And Australia growth was strong for both brands. Total Simply Good Foods retail takeaway for the 13 weeks ending May 30th, 2021 increased 29.1% in the US measured channels of IRI and outpaced the category. Now, on a margin perspective, gross margin was 42.6%. That's an increase of 140 basis points year over year. And that increase was due to favorable product form and retail channel mix given higher shopper traffic in brick and mortar channels. Now, I want to jump into Atkins Nutritionals first, give you guys some brand highlights there. Retail takeaway was up 15.6% year over year. Bars were up 4.9% and shakes were up 20.6%. The Atkins Indulge confections lineup continued to be strong at 26.7% year over year growth. Bars and shakes are up due to increased mobility, improving shopping trips, particularly in the important large mass channel, which saw a growth of about 25% in that channel and continued buyer growth. Now, jumping into some brand specific stats for Quest Nutrition, retail takeaway in tracked channels increased 56.2% year over year. Quest Bars retail takeaway increased 38%, more than double the segment growth rate. Quest Bars are also about 60% of the total Quest Nutrition retail sales, if you guys are not aware of that. Now, the snackier portion of the Quest products portfolio continued to do well and increased nearly 150% year over year, driven by chips and a launch of new confectionery items earlier in the year. Mass and convenience channels represent now about 30% of Quest sales. Growth in this quarter in those two channels were up over 60% year over year. Additionally, the specialty channel, which has struggled immensely for a number of active nutrition brands, did have a return to growth in this quarter. And then rounding out the sales channel update, e-commerce continues to grow strongly at 43% year over year, especially through Amazon, where Quest Bar continues to be the number one selling protein bar on the whole platform. Now, I want to go back to Atkins Nutritionals, and I usually spend the vast majority of these quarterly content pieces on the Simply Good Foods company on Quest Nutrition, but I do want to prioritize Atkins Nutritionals on this particular one because I think there's some things going on, at least in the environment, that could potentially help this brand accelerate some of the growth they saw in this quarter. So I do want to talk about just two specific kind of trends that I think could help Atkins Nutritionals. The first one is this idea of return to work. Now, Atkins bar consumption is highly correlated to this idea of returning to work. Now, based on if consumer mobility continues to improve, the buy rate of Atkins bars will follow. And the buy rate has recently lagged at historical low. So this is a massive opportunity for the brand. Now, it is important to note that recent workplace surveys are showing kind of like a pretty fuzzy picture in terms of what the return to work is going to look like. 6% are thinking about bringing employees back into the office all at the same time. 29% are going to bring back employees in different phases. And then 25% are saying that they're going to stagger employees or have some type of hybrid work model. So this is definitely going to make this return to work trend that Atkins Nutritionals should benefit from. It's not necessarily going to show up in these like massive like hockey puck results in terms of growth. You're definitely going to have probably more of like a step up improvement over time that's going to come from this particular return to work trend. And then there's another trend that Atkins Nutritionals could benefit from, and this is around an off-cycle resolution season. Now, companies like Weight Watchers and some of the other kind of weight management companies have been talking about this idea of an off-cycle resolution season that's going to benefit the companies kind of abnormally in the summer to fall period. This is normally a period where sales of weight management products are not necessarily all that strong. And Atkins Nutritionals brand is highly correlated with weight management. So because people are now going to have another catalyst to kind of get out, they're gonna wanna enjoy the summer months, the fall months before the school season starts up again, gonna be able to take more vacations and things. There should be a renewed interest in the weight management category. Atkins Nutritionals brand has been going through a multi-year journey in which they were replacing their funnel from a lot of like the fast weight loss customers that have been the Atkins diet brand for a long period of time and trying to transition this over to more of a low carb lifestyle approach. Now this opens them up to a much larger market. There's a lot more people that are in a more lifestyle, low carb type of weight management buying segment. And this is helping the Atkins Nutritionals brand both get a little bit younger in their customer demographics and then also more active consumer base as well. But regardless, I think you're gonna see the Atkins Nutritionals brand really ramp up their marketing spend a little bit abnormally right now during this next kind of near-term period because they are gonna try to catch a lot of these off-cycle resolution season buyers that are now gonna be reinvigorated to hopefully shed that COVID-15 that they gained during the last probably 15 or so months of the pandemic. But I do just want to end on some final thoughts. The Simply Good Foods company continues to be uniquely positioned with two large scale companies that have a ton of channel diversification in a snacking category that is still underpenetrated from a household perspective. I believe well-calculated price increases as well as some productivity gains will help them offset a lot of the inflation concerns that other competitor brands are dealing with. This will enable them to maintain their healthy gross margins and really stay on the offense and continue to look for growth opportunities. Additionally, they're spinning off about $90 million in positive cash flows quarterly. They're really getting their debt ratio down to a very healthy level, which will open up the opportunity for them to go out and seek M&A targets that will hopefully unlock a ton of growth in the next year. I continue to be extremely impressed by how well the team is operating against the complex environment, and I continue to believe that the Simply Good Foods company has a really bright future. Now, if you have any comments, questions, or thoughts on the Simply Good Foods company portfolio of brands, or maybe just the active nutrition snacking category, please make sure to leave a comment below.